with that bloodline, going fourth overall in the draft, still as a rookie, he's gotten your attention. Why?
He's got my attention because he's a gamer. He's a game changer. Unlike his brother, you know, he's not the guy that's the smoothest in through the neutral zone, but he plays the game with that edge. That edge that, you know, if you're going to play against him, he's going to push you into the board like that. He's going to give you that little shot. He's going to battle the biggest guy on your team. He's not going to shy away from it. Look at Zadorov. Zadorov's a big guy. He's not shying away from it. I know. I want that part of his game. I want to see what he brings. But, you know, he's got that X factor in front of the net. He's got the hands. He's got the middies. He's got the size. He's got the jam and the willingness to go there, if you will. So I like, you know, everything about his game. He grew up in, you know, a hockey environment. He grew up in a family where being around the rink or being a rink rat is not something that's unfamiliar to him. But what's most contagious about his play is an enjoyment of the game. He likes, you know, he likes to compete. He wants to be in the spotlight. And when you're in a pressure situation in a Canadian city where there's going to be lots of emphasis around what you do and what your team is doing, you need guys that want that spotlight on them, that want to be the guy, that want to be the difference maker. And I see that in Brady Tkachuk.
I totally do. And you know what else I see? I see a player where you don't have to lean on the player for more effort.
Mm-hmm.
There's something to be said for that for me. Because it's not just the birthright, it's not just the genetics, it's a lot of the values that you talked about, Tangs, and one of those values is respecting the game, and every time you're on the rink, be a max effort player.
Sure.
Be a max effort person. You should never have to, and I know from talking to people there in Ottawa, and their goalie, Craig Anderson specifically, he raves about Brady Tkachuk, he was also raving about Thomas Chabot, and said Thomas Chabot may be one of the best players he's ever played with already, but he said they're both very respectful. They're both good pros already at a very young age. So that's what you want. You never want a coach to have to say, hey, man, we need more effort from you in practice.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, can you ride the bike a little bit harder? Hey, can you do the stretching? He knows all of that, and he's lived by that to Tang's point. So that's something to be said for any player, let alone a first-year rookie player in the National Hockey League.
I've heard a lot of coaches say, I'd much rather have to tell you whoa than giddy up.
Correct.
Which is your point exactly.
100%.
Let me go back at you guys with the other part to this Tkachuk legacy. The bar is set high with what Matthew has done, with what Keith was the first American to lead the league in goal scoring. That was a stunning achievement back when he did it. So there's a long shadow cast, a lot of pressure. He's handled it well, going back to being drafted higher than any of the Tkachuks, the way he handled it with USA Hockey at the World Juniors. What does that tell you about his mental makeup in addition to his physical skill?
He wants that part of the game. He wants to be a difference maker. He wants to have his career not be as good as his brother, not be as good as his dad. He wants better right now, and that's what I like about him.
That's right.
I like that competitive factor that he has. You know, he's shown in the draft, you know, you could see the bragging rights with him and his brother, the fact that he went fourth, just a little higher of his brother, higher than his dad.
Right.
He let them know. So I think that he's not going to shy away from anything you're going to throw at him. He's going to be willing to have that competitive nature. We've already seen it come to the forefront. So I'm curious to see what the future is going to bring, because the Ottawa Senators, let's not forget that last year they had to make a decision whether they were going to keep that fourth pick overall, you know, with the ability to draft Brady Tkachuk, or give it away to the Colorado Avalanche and keep their pick for this year's. They decided, you know, and mostly on the fact that they were going to be able to draft Brady Tkachuk, that this was their draft pick, because they see that character, that type of character that's going to make him perhaps a captain, a future captain of the Ottawa Senators.
That's it. You have to be hungry. You have to be hungry in the wolf pack.
Mm-hmm.
You got to be hungry. The other wolves have eaten. Your dad's played in the league. He's made big cream. He's scored all the goals. He's done all the things. Team USA, you see your brother going to London, winning the Memorial Cup.
Mm-hmm.
Doing everything else, coming to Calgary, becoming a star player. You don't want to be a spectator.
Right.
Who wants to be a spectator?
Yeah.
You know what I see in them? A lot of the Sutters in them.
Mm.
In that respect, a lot of the Sutter brother family where, let's compete. We're competing. What'd you do last night? Okay, I'm going to try to outplay you. What'd you do tonight? All right, I'm going to try to outplay you. And not just rest on the laurels.
Sure.
There's not enough to just rest on the laurels. I like the tenacity and the competitive nature that they have.
If we ever see a meaningful game, you know, let's say they were to meet
in
a conference finals, in the Stanley Cup finals, the two brothers going at it, I promise you that the level of competition will be as high
as we've
ever seen anywhere across, because those two, they want to win. It's in their blood. It's inside of them. And that's what I love about watching them on the ice.
I'll give a quick story on that.
I remember
playing with Wayne Primo. Playing junior with Wayne Primo and playing in the NHL with Wayne Primo. And I don't know if those of you remember, that Wayne and Keith got into a fight.
I remember mm-hmm. that.
In the National Hockey League level, oh, yeah. Wayne and Keith fought.
Yep.
Shout out to Caden Primo, who was amazing for Team USA, by the way.
Yes, sir.
Plays college hockey at Northeastern. He was great in the World Juniors. But I got to tell you, those guys fought.
Amazing.
And it was just to your point, Tanks, that's exactly, hey, sometimes it's going to happen. So I love the fact that you're competing. You're not just spectating. You want to be in there. You're rolling your sleeves up. You never have to tell those guys to compete hard on a shift. I love seeing that.